Today in the news, Nvidia gets super spooky and AMD's 16 core is pretty quick. What's up guys, I'm Snows and this is your boot sequence. Let's get started with Nvidia. The GeForce YouTube channel just uploaded a new 16-second video with the title, Something Super is Coming. Not much more has been revealed, but by just looking at the video, it is confirmed that Nvidia has a brand new RTX 2080 and 2090 Super Edition coming to our PCs. Obviously, I'm just kidding, but the fact that it was branded with the hashtag GeForce points to it being something related to the consumer line of GPUs. The style of video and the metallic Super is definitely reminiscent of their reference coolers too. We also know that Nvidia has been very clear and persistent in separating GTX from RTX with the whole 16 and 20 differentiation. Maybe this is Nvidia's way of saying goodbye to the TI branding for their high-end GPUs and instead calling them Super, like a RTX 2080 Super or something. Nvidia does have a presentation at Computex and it is going to be on the same day as AMD's. Maybe we'll get a Super Edition of GPUs in retaliation to whatever AMD has planned. Then we have AMD. Back at CES, AMD put an engineering sample of their new Ryzen 3000 CPU head-to-head with an i9-9900K to see who had the fastest 8-core chip. What we saw was pretty amazing, with AMD winning out the battle by a little bit, but doing so at a lower power consumption. With all the rumors of 12 and 16-core CPUs popping up left and right, the question became, will it scale? Will a 16-core chip be twice as powerful as the 8-core that was shown? Well, according to one of the sources from adoredTV, yes. Yes, it will. Jim received some information for a Cinebench R15 benchmark where the 16-core Zen 2 chip had a multi-score of 4278. That's more than twice as fast as both the 9900K and the 8-core Ryzen shown at CES. In fact, it's faster than the 18-core 9980XE from Intel. This last comparison shows that AMD really has been working hard on their single-core performance. Back in October of last year, Bits and Chips reported a 13% IPC boost for Zen 2, while the latest adoredTV leak claims an increase of 12.5%. The problem is, the score we got from adoredTV kind of breaks down if you do a bit of math. The Ryzen 2700X's single core performance in Cinebench is around 175 points at 4.2 GHz. Add about 13% for the IPC increase and you get 197 points for single core. This would be at 4.2 GHz. If you scale it up to, let's say, 5 GHz on all cores, to be extremely generous, this brings us to a single core performance of around 236 points, or just under 3800 in multi-core score if we just scale the scores perfectly. Not to say that it's impossible to get the scores up to 4000s though. When you run an AMD CPU through Cinebench R15 in multi-core, it usually has a 5 to 7% higher score than if you just multiplied its single core score. But that would still put it at just under 4100 points. Unless AMD has boosted past 15% increase in IPC or has clocked their CPUs over 5 GHz on all cores, I don't see how this core makes sense right now. I know this is some extreme back of the envelope maths, but it still has some value. At least, thanks to the CES presentation demo, we have a clear-cut proof that core for core, AMD's Ryzen 3000 series has what it takes to take over the market. If you guys did your own maths or have your own theories, leave them down below. I'd love to see what you guys come up with. Then we have the Ouya. Remember the cubish Android console with one of the most uncomfortable controllers ever? Well, it looks like Razer is shutting down all of its services on the 25th of June. Do you care? Probably not, but the shutting down of the Ouya services does bring up some concerns with the future of all digital consoles, if you can even call it one. When the Ouya shuts down, you won't be able to download any of your older games, which makes sense, but at the same time, some of your downloaded games might not even function after the shutdown. Those are the games that require an online check-in, and Razer says that you should contact the game developer for confirmation. Really? Who has the time or even expects a response from a game developer on a console that is essentially dead? Alongside the Ouya, Razer will also stop selling their micro console called the Forge TV. In that case though, you'll still be able to use it by accessing the Google Play Store. That's a good way of doing it. All right, now I wanna hear from you guys. What are your guesses for Nvidia's next products? Do you think that the score for AMD's 16 core makes sense? Let me know down in the comment section. I'll be there to answer any of your questions. Anyways, that is pretty much it for the news today. Hopefully you've enjoyed. As usual, you can click right here to see the latest video, right here to subscribe to the channel. It would be greatly appreciated. Stay frosty, my dudes, and I'll see you on the next one.